Again, my name is Noya Castro with Bacovia. I am your local short sale manager. For those of you that have heard my presentation before, it has, our process has changed. I'm basically your point of contact when you list one of our properties, so you don't go to corporate with it, you're gonna come to me. We don't use Equator on these short sales. I am your Equator. I used to go out and meet with the seller to go over the hardship and explain the benefits of the short sale. That's one of the changes. I no longer do that. I cannot meet with the seller anymore. All of the big banks were audited by the OCC because they were getting complaints and that people that were trying to obtain loan mods, each time they called into the bank, they would talk to someone different, get a different answer. And we know that was happening. It's happening with all the banks. So the government said we want one point of contact from loan mod all the way through foreclosure. So with that, I can no longer talk to the seller, or I'm violating what the government's asked us to do. I'm always your point of contact. It's kind of a good thing, it's a double-edged sword, because I can't help you sell the short sale anymore. But the good thing about it is that people that continue to apply for loan mods over and over again can no longer do that. Because that one point of contact is gonna say, you know what, we went over these numbers last week, nothing's changed, you don't qualify, you need to decide what you wanna do, short sale, deed in lieu, or foreclosure. So people that were on the fence, it's really gonna make them move forward and make a decision. So that's the good thing about it. And again, the only part I don't like is that I can't help the seller, which I hardly used to do that anyway. Another good thing is that we no longer need a hardship. So as long as someone wants to short sale their property and it's one of our portfolio loans, we're going to let them do it. We're gonna let them move forward with this. So I no longer need to approve the hardship. We don't need a hardship letter, okay? So your package is the fast track form, the estimated HUD, the third party authorization, and the fully executed offer. That's all I need. I do not need any financials. So please don't send me financials because it just bogs down my email mailbox and we don't look at them anymore. We are helping with relocation costs. That's another change. Before we were guaranteeing $5,000 at close of escrow. Now we are giving $3,000 at close of escrow. That's what you can guarantee to your seller. The reason that changed is, again, the government didn't like sellers opting out of HAFA for the fast track just to get more money. And guess what? They're still opting out of HAFA. It wasn't so much the money, it's the HAFA process. Our process releases deficiency like HAFA does, helps with relocation costs like HAFA does. So we're pretty much doing everything they're doing. The only time I wouldn't really encourage someone to opt out is if there's an outside second that has to release deficiency if they go HAFA, so just keep that in mind. Our turn times have also changed due to HAFA. We have to offer HAFA to everyone across the board, whether we know they qualify for it or not. So with that, when the package comes in to me, it's intercepted by a HAFA underwriter, okay, when I send it to my team. If the seller doesn't return calls, and they typically don't when it's the bank, because they think it's a collection department, the file's gonna sit there for a minimum of 2 weeks, maybe 3 weeks, before we opt them out of HAFA. So our turn times aren't as fast as they were because of that. They can opt out up front with a letter. The letter has to be very specific as to what's on it, and I do have the instructions that I can email you on that HAFA opt-out letter. It's not something that the bank puts out, it's just something that I put on a regular Word document that I can send you with the instructions that what the bank expects on that letter. Another change is commissions. Commissions are still 6%. For husband and wife teams and two agents and your wife, 4% if you're double ending the deal. The change is that if you're able to close within 30 days of the demand, we're going to pay you an extra 1%. So it'll be 7 instead of 6 or 5 instead of 4. If there's like a husband and wife team in your office, it's 6%. Yes, just only, we cut commission if you're double in, if you're a representative. 6%. Okay. Documentation. When it comes to, if we're asking for more documentation, the only time you're going to see me do that is if the buyer has an LLC. Of course, we need the articles for that. If there's a sale date, we are going to be asking for the lender's commitment letter or proof of funds if it's a cash deal, dated within 30 days. I'm going to request a postponement from the foreclosure department. If we get it, we're only going to get 30 days. And that's a pretty hard and fast number because the bank wants to get these files through the system. So just keep that in mind. If you get a postponement and you can't close it within 30 days, chances are it's going to go to foreclosure. We won't be able to get another postponement. I'm always going to try, but policy is for the foreclosure department not to give it to us. Any questions? Yes.
Is WACA still sending out the letters to certain borrowers on the $25,000?
We are.
Is it still $25,000?
We're giving up to $25,000. If you get a demand and it says we're going to give them $10,000, that's correct. We're going to give them $10,000. It's the decision tool that decides on how much we're going to give them. Don't go out there and tell someone that the bank's could give you more than $3,000 because that's all they're going to remember. Guaranteed $3,000, but it can be more. Heads up, we're also sending out letters for deed in lieu. Okay. If your seller gets a letter for deed in lieu, but they really want to do a short sale because that's more beneficial, a deed in lieu is like a foreclosure. We will match the dollar amount that the deed in lieu department is willing to give them. And I've seen them out there for like $20,000. As long as that letter is not expired, when you send me the package and send me that letter with it, we're gonna match that. So if you have someone saying, I don't wanna do deed in lieu, or I don't wanna do a short sale because if I do deed in lieu, I'll get 20 grand, tell them we're gonna match it. But you need to get me that offer in as soon as possible. Any other questions?
Wachovia is owned by Wells Fargo, right?
Yes.
Does this include Wells Fargo?
No.
It's only Wachovia Community Trust?
Yes. It's only for Wachovia because the Wells Fargo deals, they were sold on the secondary market. So we're not the investor on those. We're the investor on the World Savings Pick and Pay. So when you farm, you want to farm Wachovia, World Savings, Golden West Financial. Golden West Financial was a parent company to World, and then Wachovia bought us out. I was a World person. Seconds, we're still paying 10% of the principal balance on seconds.
What was that again? On the second?
Seconds are 10% of the principal balance. If you are door knocking, and I'll tell you, that's what's working right now, is door knocking. I do have marketing material I can email you. It's just questions and answers about our short sales. You're already going to answer all these questions. It's to give you credibility that, you know what, I know the Wachovia program. I have a manager in the area that I work with, although you can't give them my number anymore because I can't talk to them. But you are able to tell them that and to show them the marketing piece or give it to them. If you'd like it, you just send me an email and I will send it to you PDF. We have it both in English and Spanish. Any other questions? Does it sound like a good opportunity?
Yes.
A lot of agents are not working it, believe it or not. And it's a great, great opportunity. And I'll tell you, we are moving with foreclosure. We're not sitting on these loans. There's a backlog in the foreclosure department. We have about 500,000 loans across the country that are delinquent. 200,000 of them are in foreclosure. Another 100,000 should be in foreclosure, but foreclosure is just backed up. So we have a lot out there that's delinquent. I mean, compared to other banks, we're doing pretty good, but we still have a lot out there. Yes?
Can you just send the PDF directly to Shelley? And that'll take care of it.
Okay.
Personalizable, that they can add like their name or anything.
They can't.
That's okay, they can stick their card to it.
No, you can't alter, yeah, just put your card.
So if they have a sale date, what was the deal with it? If they already have a sale date, that's a month away or?
If there's a sale date, I need the package plus the lender's commitment letter for the buyer or proof of funds if it's cash in order to request a postponement. Do you have an in-house lender?
No.
Okay, I just want to tell you guys really quick that if you're using Wells Fargo for your financing and the Wells Fargo appraisal comes in lower than our loss mitigation appraisal, we're going to use that appraisal when you're done. If it's another lender, I'm going to have to get a copy of your appraisal, appeal my appraisal in loss mid with our appraisal department to try and lower your net. And I'm going to be really honest with you, I haven't been really successful in doing that. So just keep that in mind. I did have a HUD come in last week for approval. It was off by $60,000. The lender's appraisal came in lower. We had a sale date. I got lucky that we were able to postpone it. And so right now I'm going through the whole appeal process, but if it was Wells Fargo financing, we would have been done and closed because we would have just pulled that appraisal and used it. So, yes?
Can you give me the names of the banks again that you recommended for farming? Wachovia?
Wachovia, Golden West Financial, and World Savings. Get a different answer. And we know that was happening. It's happening with all the banks. So the government said we want one point of contact from loan mod all the way through foreclosure. So with that, I can no longer talk to the seller, or I'm violating what the government's asked us to do. I'm basically your point of contact when you list one of our properties, so you don't go to corporate with it, you're gonna come to me. We don't use Equator on these short sales, I am your Equator. I used to go out and meet with the seller to go over the hardship and explain the benefits of the short. Again, my name is Amelia Castro with Wachovia. I am your local short sale manager. For those of you that have heard my presentation before, our process has changed. So that's one of the changes. I no longer do that. I cannot meet with the seller anymore. All of the big banks were audited by the OCC because they were getting complaints and that people that were trying to obtain loan mods, each time they called into the bank, they would talk to someone different. Always your point of contact. It's kind of a good thing, it's a double-edged sword, because I can't help you sell the short sale anymore. But the good thing about it is that people that continue to apply for loan mods over and over again can no longer do that.